Hello and welcome to the course of manufacturing method. In this lecture we will be talking about turning and railing. So far we have seen about cutting tool and cutting tool material and cutting fluid in the last lecture, and in this lecture we will be talking about turning and railing. This turning and railing are two different machining operation, and this machining operation we will study all the machining operation one by one. So for this lecture we will be studying turning and drilling. For turning the machine tool used is lathe, and for drilling the machine tool used is drill. So let's start our lecture with lecture objective. The lecture objective of this lecture is to know about turning operations and their class and its classification. That means what are the different type of the turning operation and the how the turning operation has been operated, that we will know. Next then we will get a basic idea about lathe and how the lathe work, or working principle of the lathe, that we will understand. And after that we will see that there is several work holding device that is used along with lathe to hold the tool, hold the workpiece in the machine tool, that is lathe for turning. Next we will see about boring. Boring is a special type of machining in that in which the pre-existing hole is enlarged. Now after the boring we will see about drilling. What is drilling, how drilling is performed, and the working principle of the drill machine, that we will see. And we will see different drilling operations such as counter boring, trapping, tapping, reaming, etc. So that would be our whole objective of this lecture. Now start with our lecture with let's start our lecture with turning. So first, what is turning? So it is a material removing process. It is none other than that machining. Turning is a machining process first. So that's why it is a material removing process in which single point cutting tool, removes the material from a rotating workpiece. That means for turning, what is happening, there is a rotating workpiece, the workpiece is rotating, and force the single point cutting tool like this. We just force the single point cutting tool, and by forcing the single point cutting tool towards the rotating workpiece, what happened, that a cylinder is generated, and this process is known as turning. This is performed in a machine tool. The machine tool used for turning is known as lathe. And there are various turning operations that can be performed in the lathe. Those are first facing, contour turning, chamfering, and threading. These are some of the operations that can be operated in the lathe. And beside this operation, there is some other operation such as knurling, such as taper turning, such as step turning. These are all the operations that can be done by using lathe. Now we will see about this operation one by one. So as a whole, what is turning? So see here in this figure, this is a single point cutting tool. So this is work part or work piece or original surface. That this surface is called work surface, and this surface is called machine surface. So what is turning? Turning is an operation in which material is removed by using a single point cutting tool from a rotating workpiece, and a cylindrical surface will be generated. See here, a cylindrical surface will be generated. This new surface is known as machine surface. So here, from here you can see three things. First, D0 is our initial diameter, DF is our final diameter, and this D is nothing but this is our depth of cut. Now in one revolution, in turning, the definition feed will be the material removed in or shift or displacement of the cutting tool per revolution, displacement of the cutting tool per revolution in the direction of the work surface is known as feed. So this is your feed, this is your feed. Now feed depth of cut is there, and this V, the spindle speed, that is your cutting speed, okay? Because cutting speed is nothing but primary speed of the primary motion. Here in case of turning, the primary motion is given to the tool, to the rotating motion of the workpiece is the primary motion, and the feed motion is given to the cutting tool, that is feed motion is your secondary motion. In case of turning, so this is your whole turning operation. So here you can see a close up view of turning operation using a titanium nitride coated carbide cutting insert. See, these are the cutting tool, that is insert cutting tool, cemented carbide insert cutting tool, and this by using cemented carbide insert cutting tool, see, turning operation is going on. And here this is your chip, and that chip is formed in case of turning operation and in case of any machining operation. Here this is a close up view, now there are several type of the operation in case of turning. So first is facing. In facing operation, what is done, the extra material, this tool feed is in the radially inward direction or in the cross feed direction. When we give the feed in the cross feed direction, that facing operation occurs. In facing operation, what is done, that the diameter of the cylinder does not change, but what is changed, its face. If this is a face, this extra part is cut out by facing operation. This extra part is cut out by facing operation. Now contour turning, in case of contour turning, what is happened, in case of contour turning, instead of feeding the tool parallel to the axis of the rotation, in contour turning tool follows a contour, means the feed is given as a curve, and as it given as a curve, the shape of the workpiece, the final shape of the workpiece will become as per the feed curve. See here, if the feed is given like this, if the feed is given like this curve, then the shape of the workpiece will be similar to that, and this process is known as contour turning. By knowing contour turning, you can understand, if we give the feed like this, that means at that time what type of the shape will be formed. At that time this type of the shape will form, this type of the cylinder will form. Why? Because we are giving at an inclination, we are giving the feed at an inclination, and this type of the shape is known as taper turning. And so by modifying the contour turning only, we can give the feed in an inclination, and by doing so, what can we achieve? We can achieve taper turning. Now there is another thing, that is chamfering. In chamfering, the cutting edge cuts an angle on the corner of the cylinder, which form a chamfer. So the corner looks like this, and by using the cutting edge, what we do, we just cut off these surfaces, and a chamfer will be there. So we just cut off these surfaces, and there is a chamfer, and this process is known as chamfering. So we just cut this part, and after that the workpiece will look like this. This process is known as chamfering, and this curve this part is known as chamfer. Now cut off by using that this turning tool, we can cut off the part of the cylinder. So here also tool feed is given radially into the rotating workpiece at the same location to cut off the end of the part. So here, if the feed is given in this location, what is happening, this part will be sheared off from the main cylinder body or main workpiece, and this process is known as cut off. Next, threading, a pointed tool is fed linearly across the surface of the rotating workpiece, work part, parallel to the axis of rotation at a large feed rate. When the feed rate is very large, it will create a thread. For thread cutting or threading, there is a arrangement in your lathe that is called lead screw. We just engage the lead screw along with the half nut, and by using the half nut and lead screw, we can make the thread by automatic feeding. Now this is a pictorial view of an engine lathe. Here the specific parts are shown. Let us show you the part. So first, there is headstock. There is headstock. In the headstock, the complete gear arrangement or motor arrangement for rotating the spindle is there. This is spindle. In the spindle, what we do, we fix the tool, we just fix the workpiece in the spindle, and this spindle rotates. By rotating this spindle, cutting speed is given. Now this is tailstock. In the tailstock, there is a center. See this center is known as dead center. Why? Because in this center, what we can do, we can see that there is a taper like shape that is called dead center, because this center does not move while machining. So while machining, only the live center, that means only the spindle or only will move. So that means only the spindle will rotate. So that means that's why this center is known as live center and this center is known as dead center. Now this is the tool post. Tool post is placed in a cross slide, and the cross slide is placed in the carriage. So this whole arrangement is known as carriage. In the carriage, the carriage is moved through two part. First, there is some wedge that is fixed on the lathe bed, and there is lead screw. This lead screw is mainly used for thread cutting or automatic feeding. And there is speed control. Speed can be controlled by the gear or motor, and feed also can be controlled by the controlling the rotation of the lead screw. Now the tool post in the carriage can give you cross slide by moving the tool post in this direction, that is perpendicular to the feed direction. What we can get the depth of cut. So, and the feed is given by rotating here is a handle. So in general manual lathe, here is some handle, and these handles are used for rotation. Now giving rotation to this handle, we can give the feed. So these are the typical parts that you can see in the engine lathe, and this lathe, you can see this lathe in your workshop also. Now we will see about some work holding device. So in this spindle, we fix some work holding device that will hold the workpiece in the spindle. So let us see about what are the work holding device. Work can be held between the centers. There can be chuck, can be used, collet or face plate. These four can be used for work holding device in a lathe. Now one by one we will see about that. In case of holding the work between the centers, there is a dog, that means that dog can be clamped to the work that is given by the dog plate, and this is work part, this is work part, and this is the center, and the other center, the other center, this is another center, this center is known as dead center, other center will be placed at the headstock end, and there is another dog plate, that dog plate is driven by the lead spindle. So by using this setup we can directly hold the device in between the centers, hold the workpiece in between the centers, and next we can use chuck. Can be three type, three jaw, three jaw dependent chuck, three jaw adjust, three jaw dependent chuck, and four jaw independent chuck. What do you mean by three jaw dependent chuck? That means in three jaw dependent chuck, the centering will be done by rotating only one jaw at a time, by rotating the clamp of the one jaw at a time. So by adjusting one jaw, two other jaws will adjust itself very clear, adjust itself. And now for three jaw rotating jack, for four jaw rotating jack, each and every jaw is rotated individually. That's why it is called four jaw independent jack. Now there is collet. Collet is a nothing but it is a three slit that permit the squeezing of the workpiece, and this is the workpiece, and this slip advance or forward or squeeze the collet. So this arrangement can be seen in collet. It can be used. It is a one type of special type of the work holding device. Next, face plate. This face plate can be used. Face plate can be attached with the spindle, and by holding the by the work is held by using the clamp. So for non-cylindrical workpiece, this face plate for non-cylindrical workpiece, the face plate is very useful. Face plate is very useful. There is special type of lathe. There is various types of lathe. In that the most effectively used lathe is engine lathe. That engine lathe we can see in the workshop. That is mainly engine lathe. And now there is another type of lathe. There is a special type of lathe that is called turret lathe. In turret lathe, various operations. So tailstock. In turret lathe, the tailstock is replaced by a turret that can hold up to six tool. And this tool rapidly brought into action by indexing the turret. So we can use this five to six tool by rotating this, by indexing this turret table, and tool post is replaced by four-sided turret to index four tools. And the application of the turret is to high production, for high production work that requires a sequence of cut of the on the part. So this is your turret lathe. Now we are coming to the operation that is called boring. In the boring operation, what will happen? In the boring operation, and turning, there is some difference. Boring is performed in the internal diameter of the existing hole, while turning is performed in the outside diameter of an existing cylinder. So, in effect, boring can be seen as a internal turning operation. So what is boring? Boring can be treated as an internal turning operation, because in case of boring, the internal hole or inside diameter of an existing hole can be machined. But in case of turning, what is happened? Turning is performed on the outside diameter of the workpiece or outside diameter of an existing cylinder. Now in that effect, now boring machine, what are the machine tool that can be used for boring, those are boring machine. And the boring machine can be horizontal or vertical. That refers to the orientation of the axis of rotation of the machine spindle. When the machine spindle rotates in an horizontal direction, that is called horizontal orientation. And if it is rotated in the vertical direction,
then it is called vertical orientation, so vertical boring machine. So this is an example of the vertical boring machine. In the vertical boring machine, there is, this is tool head, this is cross rail, and this is slide column, this is slide tool head, and this is the workpiece, this is the work table or spindle. This work table or spindle rotates, and this slide cross rail, by using cross rail or slide column and slide column, the workpiece can move up and down, up and down, and so by that we can shape the internal hole. Now another type of the operation that we are talking about, that is drilling. Drilling, what it creates? Drilling creates a round hole in the workpiece. So drilling means, drilling is an operation by which a round hole can be created in the workpiece. So it, if we compare it to the boring, which is only to the boring means, boring is to enlarge the pre-existing hole, and the cutting of the hole is done by drilling. And in drilling, the cutting tool is called drill or drill bit. And machine tool, that by the machine tool in which the drilling is done, is known as drill press. Drill press. So feed motion, in case of boring, in case of drilling, feed motion and the cutting motion, both the motion is given to the workpiece only. So in case of drilling, feed motion and rotating motion or cutting motion. See here, the cutting motion is the rotating motion of this drill bit. This is your cutting motion, and the feed motion is the horizontal motion or linear motion of the drill bit. Or so this is feed motion, this is cutting motion. So both the motion is given to the drill bit only, and the workpiece is hold still, or workpiece is stationary. So there are various two types of the hole that can be made by drill. First one is through hole. In through hole, drill exists exist opposite side of the work. So when we make a hole throughout the thickness of the workpiece, so that means that hole is known as blind through hole through hole. And blind hole, when the complete thickness is not drilled, or hole is not, hole depth is not equal to the thickness of the workpiece, at that time what we will say, at that time that is called blind hole. So that is about drilling. There are several type of drilling that we will see. So first there is reaming. Reaming is to improve the surface finish of a pre-existing hole. So it is usually used to slightly enlarge the hole for better tolerance on diameter and improve the surface finish. Next, tapping. Tapping is to provide internal screw thread on an existing hole. The tool that is used for tapping is known as tap. Next, counter boring. Counter boring provides a stepped hole in which a larger diameter follows a smaller diameter, diameter partially into the hole. So this counter boring is done for the head, bolt head, or for the screw head, etc. And this is improved by counter boring tool. This is made by the counter boring tool. Now these are the special types of the drilling, and this drilling can be done in a drill press. Drill press is an upright drill press, stands on the floor, and the bench drill is similar to this upright drill, but it is mounted on a table or bench. Now radial drill, there is some thing called there is a machine that is called radial drill. This radial drill has a large drill press, and this is mainly designed for the larger part. So this is all about drilling and turning, and I guess you will get more detail of this topic from the Kalpakjan book that I from the MP Grover book PDF that I have given. So you may go through it, but the main topics of the turning and railings are covered in the PPT only. So I guess you will find it very easily understandable, and if you have any problem you may ask during the live class. So thank you, hope you enjoy this lecture. We will discuss this in the live class. Thank you.